Okay, we'll start. In this particular class, we are going to have a detail about two tests used in speech audiometry. As we know, in speech audiometry, we have two primary types of tests. One is at the level of threshold, other is supra threshold. So these two tests are being used out. So we are going to learn about two tests which are done at the level of threshold. Threshold means just audible. Threshold means just 50% of the time. Remember that. The two tests are SDT or speech detection threshold and SRT, also known as speech reception threshold. These two. Okay. Now, SDT is detection, which means that the lowest level at which the person, nobody is a subject, the person can barely detect the presence of speech. So we are using a speech stimuli, the person says yes, I can detect, need not respond out anything, yes. Need not respond anything verbally, remember that. The materials used are monosyllabic words, bisyllabic words, spondaic words, nonsense syllables. Some questions. For example, there is a small child who is not responding out to the formal speech stimuli. So we can just call his name, Raju. No. And he just tries localizing, eye widening, cessation of activity. Any of these things which come in response to a speech stimuli would be taken up. So it has quite a bit of flexibility. The procedure is same as pure tone audiometry. It has been told to you. You try guessing out, supra threshold, go down by 10, go up by 5. Same method. The purpose for SDT and SRT are the same. And the purpose for speech audiometry is to identify out how the person is responding to speech. Because he came with a complaint that he or she is not appreciating out what people speak around him. Understood? The advantages. Now here the person need not respond out to the speech stimuli which is presented. So the first thing is that the linguistic demand and the cognitive demand on the person is reduced out quite a bit. So children who are not yet in a position to speak out, children with cerebral palsy, children with apraxia, children with autism, it works out very well. Children who have poor, or adults who have poor discrimination skills, there will be many adults who would be having some retrocochlear issues, some central auditory processing issues. So these adults would be having difficulty in actually appreciating out the speech stimuli. So such people can just respond and say, yes, I'm hearing it. Pre-linguistically deaf children. Children who have a hearing loss in the ages before which they acquire language. Deaf. Very useful. Where SRT is not possible. There are many cases in which SRT would not be possible. One of these is central auditory processing disorders, retrocochlear pathway problems. These things, SRT would not be possible. And in a country like us, India, where there are so many states, you know, 1600 languages, so it's possible that somebody comes from Odisha to Chennai, doesn't know the language Tamil. Here nobody knows how to administer out SRT in Odia, so SAT can be very helpful, huh? So these are the advantage of SDT. The next test is SRT. So as it defines, the lowest intensity level at which an individual can understand speech at least 50% of the time. And here, the demand has increased. The person has to understand, speak out the words. So the demand has, cognitive demand has increased, but to 50% of the sound. So, the instruction would be similar to PTA. Now, I am going to give you some speech stimuli. you have to repeat back them, the intensity would be reducing or increasing. Try repeating out even if you hear. If you want to guess, guess it out. Instruction would be similar to TTA because it's a threshold phenomenon, right? Materials used are spondaic words, paired words, sentences, conversation, and cold running speech. Cold running speech is a speech which does not have any intonation. It would be a flat robotic speech. Done. The procedures. Here the procedure was similar to pure tonometry. Here the procedures, there are four prescribed procedures. The first is the ascending procedure. The second is the descending procedure. The third is the ASHA recommended procedure. And the fourth is the bracketing method. What is the purpose? The purpose of both the tests, SDT and SRT, is to cross-check the pure tone audiometry. Thresholds, right? Below 1.5 kilohertz, 90% of the speech information is in there. Okay. How do you calculate the PTN? It's the average of what? 500, 1K and 2K. So this 500, 1K and 2K, this particular information actually should be correlating out with the type of perception which you have on speech audiometry. So it cross checks on the PTN. We find out the severity of the hearing loss. It helps a lot in hearing aid selection, deciding out the management of clients as well. Okay, so it's very helpful. Furthermore, it gives a confidence to the client. It helps us to address out the client's question that I am not hearing out speech conversation around me. As I said, there are four basic procedures to find SRT: ascending, descending, ASHA method, and the bracketing method. Ascending method was given by, the first method is the ascending method. The ascending method was given by Chapkin, Font, and Dixon in the year 1967. In this particular procedure, they say that we start up from the lowest intensity, let's say minus 10 decibels. We present out 6 spondees at each intensity, and then we go up ascending. It keeps going up. So minus 10, we have to present 6 spondees. 4 spondees no response means 50% and above no response. We go up, minus 10 plus 10 is 0 dB. HL, no response in first 4. So we go further, 10 dB HL, no response. We go further, 20 dB, we are going up by 10. 20 dB HL, no response. We go still further, 30 dB HL, we get one response out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? So at this point where you get one response, your threshold search begins. So once you have the threshold search starting at which intensity? 30 dB, clear? Now you will be going down by 20 dB. So the first down is by 20 dB. So the next presentation should be what? If it is 30 and you are going down by minus 20, it should be how much?
10 dB
HL. So we start up here. 10 dB HL. We present out 6 spondees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 spondees, no response. We go up by 5. Okay. So we are going up by 5. 15 dB HL. We present out 6 spondees. There is one response. We again go up by 5 dB. That's 20 dBs. And we are getting 50% response. So this is the first point of the threshold. We have to do 3 times like this. And then we find out the threshold. Similarly, there is a descending method and an ASHA method. The method which we use in the clinic is the bracketing method. Okay. So I will be talking about the bracketing method. Here, bracketing method is very handy. The reason is that you don't have to search out for the threshold. You have the PTA, you add up 20 decibels to it. Okay, the signal to noise ratio of 17 decibels is considered to be fantastic. Okay, so in a sound treated room, where it is quite round, where you are having a pure tone average of 10, let us say, adding up the signal by 20 decibel is decent enough, it's good. Okay, so we start the test of speech audiometry at PTA plus 20 dB. Okay, let's say PTA is 20 dB. So we start up the initial presentation level. The initial presentation level is 20 plus what? 20 plus?
20.
And that is 40. So we start up at 40 dB HL. Done. So 40 dB HL, we fit up the thing. We give the instruction. Now we are going to give in a set of sounds which would be paired words. These would be given to one ear, then to the other ear. You will be hearing them, and all you have to do is you have to repeat them back. No matter whether you think it's correct or whether you think it is wrong. Repeat it back. You don't hear it, you cannot repeat it back. If you hear it and think this might be the word, you can guess it out also. So, your test starts now. Put on the headphones. Say, I'm going to present out words. Present out the word. Initial presentation is 20 plus 20, that's 40 decibels. Present out three spondees. Correct? How many spondees? Three spondees. See the responses. Let's say here all the spondees have been responded. We have to find the threshold. That is 2 out of 3. Correct? 50% or more. The next presentation level would be minus 10. It's similar to the PTA, minus 10 plus 5. So it goes down by minus 10 dB, which means how much? 30 dB HL. We present it. It is 2 out of 3. So 2 out of 3 is the threshold. So in the first run, we are getting 2 out of 3 at 30 dB HL. So keep in mind, 30 dB HL. Now, again, we have to go down. By how much? 10 dB. So, 20 minus 10 is? 30 minus 10 is? 20 dB HL. So, we present it out. There is just 1 out of 3. Do we consider that or not as a threshold? No, we don't consider that as a threshold because 50%, that's 2 out of 3. Then, if it is 20 dB and it is not in threshold, we go up or down? Up by how much?
5
decibels, right? So, we go up by 5 decibels, it's 25 dB HL. Here again, we are getting what? 2 out of 3. So, again, we are getting at 25 decibels, 2 out of 3. We keep a note of that as well. Now, as we are getting 2 responses out of 3, from 25, we will go to what? Minus 10 or plus 5? Minus 10. So it comes down to, from 25 it comes down to minus 10, 15 decibels. We present it, there is no response. We go up by 5 decibels. We go up by 5 decibels, 20 dB HL. And it is one response. And then one response is not considered. So we again go up. 2 responses out of 3. This is the threshold. So out of 3 times, we got one at 30 dB. Other at 25, the third at 25. So which would be our threshold?
25
dB HL for SRT. Correct. Once you get the threshold, you start correlating it out. We know PTA plus SRT correlation clinically is best plus minus 6 decibel. And it's given by Olson. Olson said clinically PTA and SRT should be within plus minus 6 decibel. So if you take there, the PTA was 20 and the SRT was how much? 25. So is it within plus minus 6 decibels? Yes. So the PTA SRT correlation is good. Although they give a relaxation of plus minus 10 dB to plus minus 12 dB as well. But we take in plus minus 6 dB to be good. Done? SRT and SDT correlation should be plus minus 9 dB. SRT and SDT correlation should be plus minus 9 dB. This is all about the PTA, SRT and SDT correlation. Fine. Hope you understood.